In this episode, we're going to show you how to properly drill your aquarium for the shadow overflow. We're going to do a two-part series that's going to show you how to properly drill your aquarium, and then one to show you how to properly plumb the overflow. Now we're going to go over all the components that you're going to need to drill the tank. Number one is you're going to need an aquarium. You want to use either a glass or an acrylic aquarium, which is 1/4 inch thick up to 3/4 inch thick. We're going to do a glass tank in this episode with 1/4 inch thickness. You're also going to need the drilling template. The drilling template is included in the kit, and this is how you're going to align your holes to drill the tank. A tape measure and permanent marker are also going to come in handy to mark the proper location for the template. And to hold the template in place, we recommend either using duct tape or double-sided tape. And we're going to show you how to mount this in a minute. And also, we're going to use a bucket to actually catch the glass pieces as they fall from the tank after it's drilled. We're also going to need an adjustable clutch battery-operated drill. And for drilling the glass, you're going to need a diamond hole saw bit. We sell both a 63mm and a 65mm diamond hole saw bit. You can use either one of these. They will both work perfectly fine. And with drilling, you always want to keep safety in mind. So number one, you're going to need some safety gloves and safety glasses. What you see here is the drilling template that's included with the shadow overflow. On the front, you'll notice there's a sticker that shows you the approximate water level. When you're drilling a tank that's rimless, you will use this to set your water level and set the position of the overflow. When you're drilling a tank that has a plastic trim on it, you're going to do the following procedures that we're going to show you. You don't need to use this sticker at all on the front. Now we're going to show you how to align the template properly on the tank so you can drill the tank. First, you're going to use the tape measure and you're going to mark the center point of the template, which is 8 inches. We're going to mark the tank now. In this case, it's 18 inches on this 36-inch tank in the center. Now we're going to center the template in the center of the tank on the marks that we made. You can use a spring clamp at this time to actually hold the template in place while you mark the circles. Now we're going to make sure that the hole markings that we drew on the tank align properly with the rear box. You want to make sure you take the rear box with the lid assembly on it and align it with the circles that you drew. Once we've made sure that the hole alignment is proper and the lid clears the plastic trim on the rear, we're going to go ahead and drill the tank. We're going to show you how to set up the drill to drill the tank. You want to use a battery-operated drill. You don't want to use one that has a plug plugged into the wall, for the reason being that you're going to be using water to drill the tank and you don't want to be electrocuted. So a battery-operated drill, and also it's important to have a clutch on your drill. You can set the clutch to a low setting, so if while drilling the bit binds in the glass, you don't break your tank. You're going to take your diamond bit and put it inside your drill, like a normal drill bit, and then set your clutch. I like to start with like a number 5 setting. Now we're going to drill the tank. And what you need is your template, the drill, some tape, and a water source, which we have a hose here. So what you want to do first is take the template, align it over the circles that we drew on the back of the tank. And we are on the outside and back of the tank. And next, we're going to take the tape that we have. You can just tape down the template just so it doesn't move. Make sure it's aligned. Everything looks good. And before we start drilling, one important thing is make sure your tank is not tempered glass. So there's a bunch of different videos online other people have made to see how your tank is actually tempered or not. You can look at those to check it out. But in our case, we know it's not tempered, so it's safe to go ahead and drill the tank. So as we drill the tank, we're actually going to use the hose to put water over the drill bit to cool the drill bit. If you notice with our template, it actually has channels in it, and these channels are to help cool the bit and allow the water to flow through there. So keeping proper water flow on there is important. When we drill through the tank, the piece of glass that's here is actually going to fall. So in order to make sure we don't break the rest of the tank, we have a bucket, or you can put a piece of cardboard or something underneath to actually catch that piece of glass as it falls through. And last but not least, before you start drilling, you want to make sure you have your safety protection on. Gloves and glasses are number one. All right, let's get started drilling. So we're all done. We have both holes drilled now, and we're ready to install the overflow. Now that we've got the tank drilled, we're going to show you how to install the overflow. First, what you want to do is take the gaskets. You have four gaskets that are included. You take two of them, put them on the front box. Stick the front box on the inside of the tank, and push it through the holes. Take the other two gaskets, put them on the exterior side of the tank. Take the rear box, align that to the tank, and then just kind of hold it there. Get your two connecting nuts and put those on. Once you have it attached, you just want to look in there, make sure the gaskets are aligned, everything looks straight. Hand tighten the attaching nuts on there. Make sure your lid fits, and that's it. That's how easy it is to install a Synergy Reef Shadow Overflow. Thanks for watching.